So I'm up here on top of the Malahat. It's April 13th, 2010. Just coming up to pick up, looks like two more loads of topsoil are needed at the Jordans. So we're here at the West Shawnigan Lake cutoff here. That's the island highway that you see right over there. There's a sign. Cars just coming in. This is this burnt out meth lab house. Is through these trees right in here. But there's also a fill dump here that some crackheads have been dumping on their property. I shouldn't say it like that, but looks pretty obvious once you see what's on the other side of the trees. Anyway, look, they got a UH-171 right here. I figured I'd film this. It's an old M&B machine. I've been a little reluctant to come in and film it, but I've got a little spare time today. You can see what's going on here. Digging with the shanks, welded on some sort of haphazard thumb. Nice looking old Kenworth there, hauling a load of boulders. This guy's all over the place. He's in Couch and Valley up here all over. Anyway, back to the story. Here's our UH-171. This machine was sitting in Duncan on the side of the road there by the Rishi distributors for the longest time too. And the packings and the cylinders have been completely blown out. They've gone all over the ground. And as I see, it's got the old Kid fire suppression system in the back in there from its M&B days. Just looking over the bucket. Now this could be a UH-172. See, they've scrapped the toolbox off the machine here, the old Cypress guarding package. And this is actually a UH-172. And this is with the upgraded pump, I think, in it there. It's got a third pump. I think that's the difference between the 171 and the 172 is this. And you can see the remnants of where it said that right on the side. And this has the full Cypress package on it from back in the day. You can fish plate it a few times there up on the boom. Good old Warrior. I guess it knocks down the piles here whenever they get a little too high. They put her back into duty. You can see what's going on in the backyard of that place over there. So, and I did a quickly licky paint job with the M&B red there, and the orange is showing through. No fuel tank on this truck, on this one here on the back. Bunch of crap, old ghetto blasters and stuff on the ground. I'm waiting to see the diapers and the needles. But yeah, that's our UH-172. I believe this has the extra pump that's in it. That's all I know. I know this is the same. The UH-171 is the same as the UH-14-2. But the UH-172 is different than the UH-171. Same size, just different internals. But this is the excavator here. Gotta climb up on it, big Hino in it. I see he's got the Indian carry backpack there for the old piss cans, got two of them on the back. And this is a UH-14-2 boom on it, it says, for the spec. You hear the rifle range across the road there. This is for sale for the longest time. I bet you it probably digs good gravel. Chapman Industries. Door's all split in half. It's the old nitrogen accumulator. The old pedals. Our meter quit working at 66.52. And there's the key for the oil spill box. Yeah, she's an old road warrior. Anyway, time to get going. I gotta go and get one more load of topsoil. But yeah, there's the machine. There's an old M&B red there. You can still see the M&B logo on the door there. And there we have it. There's the pin that you pull on the side there for the nitrogen. This never had that thumb on. I was put on after the fact. It's old Beals. Got a quick attach. It's for sale. There's the number. You guys want to call it? For sale. There's the crackhead place right there.